I don't want a crumb left on that plate, girl.
Auntie Ethel, please. One more bite and this pie is gonna come back up to say hello.
Don't make me get the wooden spoon. You're eating for two, so get to it. Oh, if it isn't my hero. You took ages. Come in, come in. Feel free to relax yourself and have a cuppa, hmm? Gods, grant me patience. Eat up, Mayrina. I won't say it again. Keep that hole under your nose shut, or things will get messy.
What is it? What's going on?
You want to play it like that? Fine. Yes, girl. I killed your brothers.
That can't be true. Auntie Ethel.
They were being rude, and I detest rudeness.
You monster! The deal is off!
Enough! Away with you. Last silence at last. Some time in the cage should do her good. And you, you'll regret sticking your nose in my business.
You blink and the wilderness changes. A swamp, stinking and insidious, assaults your senses.
I see the hell you spit out another tragic little with your new friends. Bye-bye.
I can't have gone far.
Thank you.
my way.
You are as thick as they come, sweetness. This is my personal playhouse, and you don't have an invite. Get out! Has that wriggler eaten your brain already? Leave, or you'll end up in tonight's stew. We'll go nicely with Mayrina. She's already marinating.
What is this place?
Don't look. Don't!
Maybe I need more pockets.
You feel crushing waves of fear as the presence within the door recoils. It can't let people through, not again. A scene appears in your mind. Two paladins and a cleric marching through the door, shrouded in the glow of the divine. Weapons brandished, they charge into the hag's lair. Screams of terror pierce the air.
You let them in? Naughty. That's a decade for each. You're mine for 30 more years, Petal.
You see an image of blue skies and sunshine as the door shudders a warning. Run. You see the hag. She walks through the door, its form shimmering. The lightest touch of hope brushes your mind as the presence within retreats.
Wait. Don't look. Don't!
Don't want to draw any attention. Shouldn't have wished to live in more interesting times. Makte Bartute.
Auntie.
lost. Hope this ends well. Best be on my way.
I'll break their pretty little bones.
This Medicatrix!
Don't make me do this! Thank the gods!
You're everyone's punching bag, and no one's better. will celebrate.
No time for mercy.
Mundus vult dicipi.
I see the hell spit out of not unchanging little tiefling.
make me hurt them.
Bloody clever clubs! You're everyone's punching bag and no one's favorite. Wait! Oh! Wait just a tick! Killing me is a waste of time. I'll find a way to return. Always have, always will. But it's unpleasant. So how about we be civilized about this, I have something you want. If you're gloating now, just wait till you hear my offer, Petal. Let me leave with the girl, and I'll give you power. You want to be stronger, tougher, smarter? Done! Anything is possible. Just let me keep the girl and her babe. It's your choice, sweetness. Not a hope. It's one or the other. him. Have it your way. I'll rip your throat out, yes, you little bollocks.
I'll burn you alive. Everyone will celebrate. I see the hell spit out another tragic little team.
Dead. I don't even know if she can die.
I thought I was lost. Could feel my mind slipping away. If it weren't for you, I would have ended up like the others, hollowed out and as good as dead. Sheer desperation. My mother's mind is gone. She's forgotten herself. I tried medicine, magic, prayer. I'd have begged Merkel himself if I thought he'd listen. Heard about this wise woman out in the back end of nowhere who could help. I knew it was too good to be true, but I didn't care. Home. To Baldur's Gate. This isn't over yet.
You think Ethel was the only hag in the realms? Not by a long shot. There's more hags out there, and I'm going to do what I can to make sure no one else has to go through what I did.
I'm so stupid! How could I have trusted her? I almost gave that monster my child! That's what she wanted! My baby! And gods, I was going to do it! For him! My husband. She was going to bring him back. Bring Connor back to life. I have nothing, all right? Ethel promised to raise the child, teach them magic, give them a good life. It's a damn sight better than I can do. I just wanted everything back. Back the way it was. It's my own fault for letting her. Look, I don't like owing people. Here, this socket is worth some coin. Really? That's... My husband gave it to me. I should take him home. His coffin is just upstairs. A decent burial is the least I can give him. Thank you. I don't think there's anyone else who would have saved me.